Kenny's getting his jazz on.
Woohoo!
A little artistic stuff. What's up, buddy?
That's right.
Go, Kenny,
that's
go.
The jazz snap.
Never had one lesson.
You gotta have a jazz snap. Yeah. One lesson. Okay, we're at the Cleveland Museum of Art, and they have a really cool exhibition here. Steve has worked for 4.5 years curating to bring all this to us, and it's tremendous. He has left no stone unturned. First of all, Steve, let's go right here. This is a, tell me about this Chanel bottle.
Very, very rare bottle, original bottle of Chanel No. 5, which was designed in 1921.
Wow, and even Chanel wants that bottle, and then the private owner is like, nope.
Can't. Yeah, there's only a few left in the world, and wow, this one's in New York.
Okay, very good. So you run the gamut. I mean, of course, we see the Josephine Baker reference back there. Totally love that. She was a big part of the 20s.
Absolutely.
And so was fashion.
Absolutely. You know, it was a time when women threw off their corsets and had these beautiful dresses that shortened their skirts, bobbed their hair, and danced into the night.
Pretty much they just let loose.
Absolutely.
And then you have to accessorize if you're going to look that good.
Well, of course you need diamonds, rubies, sapphires, emeralds, and we've got them all.
Right. And so it was a really great time for jewelry designers as well, as we look at this.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Cartier, Van Cleef & Arpels, all the great names, Tiffany & Company. This was a great era for accessorizing.
It's really when they cut their teeth.
Absolutely.
Now we look at art over here. This is a famous jazz depiction over here.
Yes. Artists during the 1920s really depicted life as it was, you know? And a painting like this beautiful example by Archibald Motley called Blues really shows the pulse and the pace and the life of a nightclub in Paris.
And then Gershwin right here.
George Gershwin, this was his era. Mm-hmm. 1924, Rhapsody in Blue was debuted in an experiment in modern music, was the title of the concert.
Wow. And we go through here, there's gems of architecture, there's gems of furniture. There's a really, you really don't realize what a tremendous influence the 20s had until you kind of see the way you have it all laid out.
Well, thank you. Yes, this room, it really looks at the traditional side of design during this period.
Mm-hmm. And we have to show this amazing chandelier. There's a song out, Chandelier, now, but it pales in comparison to this chandelier. Let's talk about this.
This was a 1925 World's Fair gem. Mm-hmm. This was shown in Paris in that year, and many Americans went to that fair and would have seen this in the Pavilion of Baccarat, where this was hanging.
And how many different crystals?
Well, I had my intern count them, and they're almost 30,000 crystals.
30,000 crystals, and this was at the World's Fair in Paris in 1925.
That's right.
Real quickly, before we end, what do you hope people really learn about this period?
I hope people come away thinking how glamorous and amazing it really was, and how much color. You know, we look at the 1920s in black and white all the time.
Right, right.
And in fact, it was a colorful, beautiful, sparkling era.
Awesome. Okay, here at the Cleveland Museum of Art, well done, Steve. Great job. 4.5 years these guys have been putting this thing together. So you have to come out just for Steve's sake.
Thank you, Kenny.
No problem. When we come back, lots more to show you. Stay with us.
Fox 8 News in High Definition is brought to you by Nissan of North Olmsted and I-90 Nissan. Woo!